had a very productive morning. We started our morning here in Forsyth County at Glenn High School. Glenn High School is a very accurate representation of Forsyth County. The student population is roughly 40% Caucasian, 20% African-American, and 20% Hispanic. So just as diverse as Forsyth County is, Glenn High School really fits that mold. Importantly, when the school performance grades came out for Glenn High School, the first year, Glenn was graded at a D level. Then the second year, Glenn was graded at a D level, but importantly, only missed the mark by just a few points. And I was talking to the principal at Glenn High School. He said, at that moment, we all told ourselves, we are not a D grade high school. So together with the staff, they implemented policies, collaborated, and with teamwork, raised their school performance grade in just a very short span of time. I wanted to know, how is it that they were able to raise that grade? First, community. The teachers and staff at Glenn High School don't just use the word community, they are a community. When you walk into Glenn High School, there's a photo of the principal and staff and teachers, and they call it the family portrait. They have each other's backs. This is important because when I sat down with a small group of teachers, and it was just me and them, to hear what works and what doesn't and what they need from someone in Raleigh, those teachers told me every teacher at Glenn High School has high expectations of the students in their classroom. Because if just one teacher doesn't have high expectations, students will know that they can have lower expectations in that class and try to have lower expectations in other classes. So it takes every teacher being on point to have those high expectations. Second, professional development at Glenn was a priority. They only have all staff meetings just once a year at the beginning of the school year. After that, they take their professional development time in professional learning teams to collaborate with teachers who are on their core subject matter. And teachers told me that they really felt that sense of community between the veteran teachers and the newer teachers. A true mentorship was forming that would allow the veteran teachers to give the classroom management skills, the subject matter skills, all that coaching to the newer teachers. And the reason I'm on a listening tour is because when you truly listen to what's going on in our schools, you will always learn something new that works. At Glenn High School, they realized something that I experienced when I was teaching in high school. There were students not reading on high school level. But high school teachers don't intrinsically have the skills to teach reading. High school teachers teach more to the core subject. They teach more vocabulary. If you're in a science class or a civics class, you're teaching vocabulary, not the core fundamental reading. So when they realized they had students struggling to read, the principal got professional development for his teachers targeted on reading skills. Now when I talked to a small group of teachers, I asked that no one from the central office joined, and it was just me and the group of teachers, so they could feel able to speak very frank with me. They are concerned about the teacher pipeline. The way the teacher pipeline affects them is that idea of high standards in every classroom. For better or for worse, if a classroom has a permanent substitute teacher, the classroom management, the core academics, those standards might not be as high as if you have a permanent teacher in that situation. Well, what does that do when that student goes to the next subject? That student might not be prepared as they could have been if they had a teacher that was having high standards. And of course, community is vital. The younger teachers told me that they really felt like they could lean on the older teachers for advice. Now, that was only possible because the older teachers were putting themselves out there to support the younger teachers. And technology. There's a lot of excitement about technology, but as I've been saying, technology is just a tool for the teacher. Without the right teacher in the classroom, technology will not be the single bullet answer to our issues. After a great visit walking around Glenn, seeing teachers in action, I sat down just now with some business leaders. We talked about how the two biggest issues facing businesses now in North Carolina are rising healthcare costs and also the cost of talent acquisition. And they really want schools to get in front of students at a younger age and educate them on what potential career opportunities could be. And there really needs to be a rethinking of what it means to have vocational education. It is not something where students are told, you're not college material. You're not fit to go to college. This is something where every student who wants to can go to college, but you need to know your options. Because if you want to get out of high school and be a lineman for a power company, in a few years, you could be making over $100,000. If you want to get out of high school and go right to a steel fabrication company as a welder, right out of high school, you might be able to be making $70,000. These are options that the business community wants students to know and then wants substantial workforce development to tie into getting students those opportunities. But today, I am excited to talk about a program that was brought to me by IBM. And as I said, I've been doing a lot of listening, not just to teachers and principals and school leaders, but also to stakeholders who have been coming to Raleigh to talk about tools that they have that can help teachers and students. One of those that I loved because it was free is the Teacher Advisor with Watson. And if we can watch a quick video very quickly, and then I'd like to talk about what help I'd want from teachers on this.
Quality lesson plans that you know once you're in there poking around, whatever you choose, for whatever standard you're working on, it's going to be effective.
So starting in grade three, it really does start all of the new mathematics that is going to be helpful, that helps them on when they move to the 6th to 8th grade span, and then the 9 through 12.
We invited in all the key partners to have a workshop where they could see the Watson technology, understand it, and then brainstorm how we could work the needs of education and educators in the most significant way, designed to help individual teachers to be more effective, and more effective teaching will lead to more effective learning.
Teacher advisor should be called teacher's best friend. This tool is really for all teachers to pinpoint what they need when they need it. You can choose from the variety of activities depending on the students that you see every day, so you know very well what they need in order to make gains. It's all right there for you, teacher advisor.
So the teacher advisor with Watson uses Watson's cognitive ability to where teachers can go type in a natural question, and Watson can understand that to bring back suggestions for that teacher on how to address specific issues that teacher might be having in the classroom. On top of that, it can suggest lesson plans. And if the teacher wants, with those lesson plans are materials such as worksheets. Watson being such a sophisticated device, the more teachers use it, the better it becomes at suggesting the best effective results for teachers. This made me think of how at Glenn High School you have experienced teachers helping the newer teachers with providing them with lesson plans. This is a tool where newer teachers or even experienced teachers who want to address an issue in a different way could simply go log in to Teacher Advisor by Watson and get solutions and suggestions right there. But importantly, just as I'm on the education and innovation tour listening, I'm not going to say this is the magic bullet. I'm encouraging teachers to go try this, use it, it's free, sign up, and then let me know what you think about it. We will be launching this weekend a Facebook page, NC Superintendent Mark Johnson, where teachers can go and communicate directly with my office on what works, what doesn't. And one of the things I'd love feedback on is how have you interacted with the teacher advisor with Watson, and what do you think about it? Is it the type of solution that we need to help teachers in our schools? So thank you very much for coming out. I do hope that teachers take advantage of this resource and let me know what they think. And I want to thank the Winston-Salem Forsyth County Schools for hosting us today, and the business leaders as well. So thank you all very much.